press freedom in Nigeria is a lot better than it was in the days of the military, but journalists are still at risk for the kinds of stories they do. I think the effect of the kind of censorship on freedom that journalists have in Nigeria is that journalists are now wary of the kinds of stories to cover, and they say, oh, corruption in the oil and gas industry is a no-go area. Reporting on terrorism is a no-go area. You know, so journalists are forced to back off from certain stories. I think that's a bigger threat than the direct clampdown on journalists by the government or by the military. I like to describe myself as not the everyday journalist, but a journalist on a mission. I studied agriculture-related courses across two universities, and I graduated with a degree, a Bachelor of Science degree in animal science. I should ordinarily be tending to animals.
Fisayo Soyombo wrote a five-part series on the plight of soldiers injured on the battlefield with Boko Haram. After publication, the Nigerian army accused him of committing subversion, a treasonable offence punishable by death.
It's risky, people warn you, oh, don't do this, but you must be convinced it's something you want to do. And I am convinced that my intentions are altruistic and I can't afford to back off.
Fisayo Soyombo.
Journalism is a tool that one can use to advance the society. I give you an example. I was in the northeast to report on the neglect of soldiers injured while fighting Boko Haram. And I spoke with dozens of soldiers. Only one had the confidence to reveal his identity, his full name. And after the story, the Nigerian military gave him a prosthesis. This is someone I met on crutches. And that was in May. Last week, I went back, I found this soldier, he had a prosthesis, I did a video of him, he was walking, I was fulfilled. And that fulfillment for me is not negotiable.